So remember the 2x2 matrix that we drew a while ago. We'll now have a closer look at this matrix, as promised. So what we just found out, by the way, is that this part here, anything you can do on a non-deterministic RAM in polynomial time, can also be done on a deterministic RAM in exponential time. So any problem that is in this part down here would also be in this part up here. But since we're mainly interested in polynomial time, let's focus on the bottom part of this matrix for now. We'll come back to the full matrix in later units when we talk about exponential time complexity classes. And remember that each of these squares contains all of the problems that can be solved in polynomial time, the left one on a deterministic RAM and the right one on a non-deterministic RAM. And now we'll give these names. So we'll call this complexity class here P, because those are all problems that are solvable in polynomial time on a deterministic RAM. And we'll call this here NP, because those are all problems solvable in polynomial time on a non-deterministic RAM. Of course, it would have been more consistent to call this one down here DP or something like that, but this is the way we name it. And now what we also know is that any problem that can be solved in polynomial time on a deterministic RAM can also be solved in polynomial time on a non-deterministic RAM. We should probably redraw those black lines here like this, because any problem that is contained in P is automatically also contained in NP. But of course not vice versa, otherwise we would know that there's a polynomial time algorithm for vertex cover and the two other problems. So P contains all the problems that we know are easy. So for example, finding the shortest path between two points in a graph, or looking up an entry in a database, multiplying two numbers, and thousands of problems more. So basically any algorithm you'll have come across in an introductory algorithms course will fall into this category. And again, there's some theoretical nitty-gritty regarding optimization and decision problems here, but we can ignore that for the time being. So let's do a little quiz to summarize what you know by now. So given all you've learned, what can you say about P and NP? So I would like you to check which of these statements are true. The first statement is every problem in P is also contained in NP. The second statement is that every problem in NP is also contained in P. The third one is that P and NP are in fact equivalent. The fourth one is that it seems like NP should contain more problems than P, or be larger than P, but we can't really say for sure. The fifth one is that vertex cover, independent set, and click are contained in P. And the final one is that those three problems are contained in NP. So please check every statement which, given what we know by now, you should consider to be true.